on their glory, because the U.S. dollar used to be up on the hierarchy, man.
Yeah,
it was once it still is going down, but it's the world reserve currency. That's what everybody got to do to going back to what you were speaking on, to purchase oil from different nations. They got to transfer their currency into American currency to make a purchase. But they moving away, like you said, the other nations.
Habakkuk 2:16, thou art filled with shame for glory. Mm-hmm. Drink thou also and let thy foreskin be uncovered, mm-hmm. which is their wickedness, man. And all the shit that they've done. Now, as the scriptures do say in Isaiah 47 chapter, man. You know, let the thigh be uncovered, man. Esau, Edom, and wickedness is now being exposed, you know, and now the Lord is starting to show, you know, that he's not really dealing with them, man, like they were led to believe. It says, the cup of the Lord's right hand shall be turned unto thee.
Yeah, and so-called white people born in slavery, man.
That's right. And shameful spewing
just like we did
on thy glory. And that shameful spewing is that shame in which they don't receive, in which they've already begun to receive, man. You know, shameful spewing shall be on that glory, like this guy Mark Zuckerberg with the Facebook shit and all the allegations coming up against him. They asked him to step down as the chairman, as the CEO.
Yeah,
man.
Well,
that shameful spewing.
The lawyer for Donald Trump, that nigga Michael Cohen, he just got 3 years in fucking prison, man.
Right.
Shameful spewing upon that glory, like the brother exactly. talking about. And then you got, I believe that dude, the secretary, James Mattis, he fucking up on some charges, too. He probably get sentencing, too, man. All right, real soon, man.
There's a lot of wicked shit going on with these wicked priests, okay? The pedophilia that goes on, in which they now getting caught, they say, like, over 300, you know? You can look this shit up on Google, man.
Yeah, the scripture talk about shame for spewing shall be upon that glory.
That's not the truth, man. The truth is not in them churches, man. And also, it's, hey, man, y'all ain't got the truth, man. You know? How about Shem Yashah expose y'all for being the son of perdition, the son of destruction, because you destroyed everything, including the minds of these people on this side. You destroyed the minds of those pedophiles, those little boys you done took by force. You destroyed the minds of these people to where they under gross darkness. You destroyed the earth we living in, you see? And someone got to pay for this shit, okay? Revelation 11 and 18. The Lord going to destroy him was destroyed the earth. Look at the chemtrails. Look at the GMO foods, man. Okay? Look at the fluoridated water, which they say that shit can eat through concrete, man. You know? Yet they saying it's safe for you to ingest it.
Go ahead, who had that? Oh, yeah.
Jeremiah 49:7.
Right.
Concerning Edom, thus saith the Lord of hosts, is wisdom no more in Teman? Is counsel perish from the prudent?
Right, because Teman is the modern-day Turkish, right? Which the Turkey, those so-called Turkeys, they the smartest out of all the Edomites, man. All right? You know? But the Lord going to take all that wisdom away, man.
It's like,
yeah, that's where it comes. That's right. Yep, that's Teman, man. Germans, Turkey. Go ahead, you got it.
It says, is there wisdom vanished? It says,
yeah, come.
Flee.
You go down like the 12 or something about what you're saying.
Yeah, pretty much their wisdom vanished in so many words because they don't have, they thought they had the technology to do everything. They can't prolong their life, you know. They can't add one cubit to their stature, you know. They got all this knowledge, wisdom, and understanding, but they can't do the simplest things, man. Even like receiving their birthright back, you know? Right, so he said, his wisdom going out of team, and they no longer these wise people no more, you know? Hey, these other nations got weapons of mass destruction just like they got, so they on an equal, you know, playing field with them and shit.
Man. Right, yeah, they got all this wisdom, but they can't do nothing against the so-called UFOs, though.
Right.
But they got all this damn wisdom. Right, but yeah, where's all this wisdom going to come into play, man? Right. That shit ain't gonna come into play right. When the Heavenly Father sent his glory, man, amongst the heathen, what is all that wisdom?
Hey, they had all the wisdom the Lord could have, but the Lord told these Edomites what they could do to get their birthright back. He gave them a simple instruction. You want your birth, if you could do away, you know, with the ordinances, and the Lord told you what to do to do. Hey, you doing all this extra other shit that ain't working. So that goes to show you they don't have no wisdom.
Go ahead.
Jeremiah 49:8. Ye turn back, dwell deep, O inhabitants of Dedan, for I will bring the calamity of Esau upon him.
Hey, Esau in the Bible is you damn Caucasians, alright? So y'all know that. Y'all read about Esau in the Bible, it's you so-called white people, alright? You damn Edomites. That's y'all real nationality. Hey, you so-called Negroes, man, y'all Israelites, dumb fucks. Go ahead. Yeah, you shave your beard, you break the law, that's a commandment, big head nigga.
I don't know where they are, so. The time that I will visit them. If grape gatherers come to thee, would they not leave some gleaning grapes?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the so-called white man, he a damn hoarder. The elites of the nation of Israel, the nation of Edom, that's what it's gonna go into. How they all fucking living in the lap of luxury, you know, living deliciously, faring sumptuously, when they goddamn Edomite counterparts is out here struggling.
Yeah, you should never see a homeless Edomite. How you homeless in your kingdom? That's how you know, man.
They
treat
it, man.
Yup. He says, if these by night, they will destroy till they have enough.
Huh.
But I have made Esau bare.
Yeah, the Lord said he made Esau bare, right? When you make somebody bare, when you born bare butt naked, man, all right? When you bare, that means you totally exposed, man, all right? So the Heavenly Father said he made Esau bare. All right, he exposed the so-called white man, okay? By what? The wisdom understanding of the scriptures, man, through the apostle elders of great millstone. Start with the apostle on down, man, who learned from their elders and apostles, man, you know? Hey, through the internet, man, because, right, the internet was made for the elect of the nation of Israel. That's another way the Heavenly Father made Esau bear, man, because you could go and Google anything about this damn devil, you know? About his different, you know, how, like his different crafty councils that he got,
got
you know?
That go
yeah, go ahead, yeah.
Hey, all true.
We going there, right.
They got heart programs.
Right.
They got to know some weather modification.
Yep.
The MK Ultra got to do with fucking with your brain and trying to control your people. The RFID chip, that's an operation that they want to do on your people, a physical one, okay, where you got to come in and receive an incision. They got Jade Hill, you know, them pretty much urban areas.
And you can look all this up on the internet.
Agenda 21.
Project, you know, Megiddo, all this shit.
This new world
Operation
order,
Cable Splicer. You know, right, it's so much stuff, and you can look all this stuff up on the internet.
Rabbit hole goes deep, man. It's too much, really, you know, for people to try to get, man. You know, your focus, you gotta build your word, man. Real talk, because you ain't got long. The Lord said that the doors of the temple shall be closed. And get Hosea 13:14. Whoever
want to
read it,
you want
to swap out here.
Oh, yeah.
What's that? 13:14.
You get that name? 13:14. Hosea 13:14. I will ransom them from the power of the grave.
Where's the Heavenly Father get? He tells you in Ezekiel, and these dry bones live. You know, these dry bones being the Israelites who was in this low, decrepit state of mind, man, in which they still are to this day. But out of that remnant, he has a portion according to grace rule. He's actually bestowing his knowledge and understanding unto. How about Shimei Shah got a lecture according to grace, who not gonna bow the knee to the image of all who he's suffering with, man. And he said he ransomed them from the power of the grave, man. Because they were dead in their sins, had not he sent Yahweh Shah on the cross, man, to die for them. You got it?
Hosea 13:14, I will ransom them from the power of the grave. I will redeem them from death. O death, I will be thy plagues. O grave, I will be thy destruction. Repentance shall be hid from my eyes.
He said, death, I will be thy plague, man. Because death is going to be swallowed up in
that man.
He already overcame that, man. Just like we're going to overcome it if we endure it to the end. But he said, the doors of repentance shall be closed. So right now is the time that you got to try to get the word. Because you ain't going to always have this opportunity. The scriptures do speak about observing the opportunity, man. So you gotta seek to your help by Shimei Shah. Hey, I get Baruch 4:1 as well.
Look.
It's Amos chapter 8, verse 11. Behold the day, Slaka. It's Amos chapter 8, verse 11. Behold the days come, saith the Lord Yahweh, that I will send a famine in the land. Not a famine of bread, nor a thirst for water, but of hearing the words of the Lord.
Famine is coming. The prophets no longer been on the highways and the byways to give your people warning, to give you understanding. As the Lord did say in the book of Ezekiel, that we shall be dumb unto them and no longer a reprover. Okay? So the men ain't gonna always be out here. Once again, alluded to the doors of repentance being closed. The Lord withdrawing his hand back. You
people who don't got the word, then you're going to die in your iniquity, man. Rightfully so. And I'm not going to lose an ounce of sleep, man. I actually rejoice to it. If it be your Haba Shemi Al-Shah, we'll drink to it, man. Okay? So, hey, man, now is high time to wake out of sleep, man. Now is salvation nearer than we believe. Okay? That Romans 13:11. Go ahead with that precept you got,
Luke 4:1. This is the book of the commandments of Yahweh and the Lord that endureth forever.
Right.
All they that keep it shall come to life.
That's right, because the main purpose we'll be out here for is for you Israelites to come back into your power. That's what we out here standing up in the cold for. Alright, dealing with you niggas, these heathens, having to suffer all this extra hell, is to tell you Israelites to repent. Get into the basics, you know? To tell you to come back into your house, you know, forsake your wicked way, leave off from sin. Which the scriptures talk about as
Yo, bro.
Go ahead, you got it,
bro. Let me start back from the top.
Hey, come up a little closer, just a little.
Baruch 4:1. This is the book of the commandments of Yahweh, and the Lord that endureth forever. All they that keep it shall come to life, but such as heathen shall die.
That's right, so all that keep it shall come to life. If you keep what's written in the scriptures and endure to the end, the Lord is going to keep his word, man. He's not a man that he should lie, okay? So he's going to do his part. We got to do ours. Go ahead.
Turn thee, O Jacob, and take hold of it.
That's right.
Walk in the presence of the light thereof.
That's right, man. So he said, take hold of it. And also he said, hey, man, hold fast which thou hast, man. You know that no man take that crown. You receive this knowledge and understanding. Go that way, man. Go that way, man.
Oh, excuse me.
Damn devils, man. Damn Edomites, bro. They got to die, man.
Wife checking
them. Yeah. That's the spirit. Then how about Shimei Al-Shah, man? Reproving his ass. Go ahead.
Baruch 4:2, turn thee, O Jacob, and take hold of it.
That's right.
Walk in the presence of the light thereof, that thou mayest be illuminated.
That's right. He said, walk in the light thereof, that thou mayest be illuminated, man. All right, so ultimately, you could say, are the true Luciferians, the light bearers, man, on the right-hand side of the Heavenly Father. Because we're out here exposing this devil for all his wickedness that he's done. All right, and still is doing behind you, under your people's noses. You know, y'all ain't aware of half the shit this devil is doing and planning on doing in regards of running the dollar bill into the ground and implement a RFID chip, okay? Hey, get that sign in there, got it, chip. Because that's future prophecy in which you people need to be warned on, man. You so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native and Seminole Indians, as well as you confusion of faces scattered abroad, man. All right, y'all need to be up on the fact that they about to try to implement this chip in you people, man, and do away with your dollar bill, which is why they crashing it, man. If you pay attention to the stock market, the D.O.W. Jones is constantly dropping, constantly falling 400 points here, 500 points there, all right? The NAS, the DAQ, whatever they call it, the NASDAQ, whatever.
NASDAQ,
okay?
Yeah.
Hey, Genesis 47 and 15 talk about the men of money failed in the land of Egypt, man. So it's no new thing under the sun. It's here it is about to happen again, and your dollar bill is not backed by gold or silver, man. So this is going to affect all you people because you all use the dollar bill. Hell, they getting ready to go to a cashless society. They already doing so by doing away with the dollar, by implementing the credit card with the chip in it, which is gradually programming your mind to say, do you have a chip, man? And now it's about to be mandated. You got the original sign up.
Yeah, they pushing the chip in all those, in like India, all those other countries, the elites of the world, they pushing it over there in these other countries, just seeing the reaction they get out of the people, man. It's soon to come to America, man.
And everything we saying is Googleable. You can type in 3 Square Market on Google and see that that company already done bought and paid for a chip party for its employees, which is already here on the American soil, all right? And this is prophesied some 2,000 years ago with the scripture right at the bottom, man. And we prove all things. You can get it if you want. Go ahead.
This is Ecclesiastes 12:1. Remember now thy creator in the days of thy youth, while the evil days come not.
Right. So he's saying, remember now your creator in the days of thy youth, when the evil days come not. Right now your creator is Jehovah Shimei Al-Shah, who people ignorantly call God and Jesus Christ, man. Right? And that, hey, the reason you're calling them names, a lot of people be dropping dead for calling on those false idols. Like tomorrow, all right, they about to have Christmas Eve. They about to be celebrating that man-made pagan-ass holiday, man. And a lot of people going, hey, get judged for doing so, man.
That's right.
Not knowing that shit goes back to Nimrod's erect penis, man.
Jeremiah 10?
Yeah, that goes, you can hold that too, but I want to get that chip first, that prophecy.
Revelation 13, 16.